got together on a sawdust floor. God was there, you couldn't ask for more. We all fell in love last night in a gospel way. I love to hear my mama sing and shout and tell how the Lord has helped her out. We all fell in love together in a gospel way.
Well, praise the Lord, everybody. This is yours truly, the evangelist Willie Grizzle from the House of Prayer Radio Ministry. If you like a prayer, please leave it in the comment area. Hey, if you'd like personally to email me at brothergrizzle76@gmail.com, or you can contact me through Facebook, Evangelist Willie Grizzle. Stay tuned. We'll be on shortly, and we're just going to obey God in the spirit and truth. Love you guys.
You better be ready when he comes around. Let's all fall in love together in a gospel way. I've heard some people curse his precious name, but we all know God stays the same. Let's all get a little bit closer in a gospel way. Let's all get together on a sawdust floor. God is there, you can't ask for more. Let's all fall in love tonight in a gospel way. I love to hear my mama sing and shout and tell how the Lord has helped her out. Let's all fall in love together in a gospel way. Let's all fall in love together in a gospel way. And we'll all get to heaven together in a gospel way.
Well, praise the Lord, everybody. This is yours truly, the evangelist Willie Grizzle from the House of Prayer Radio Ministry, saying howdy. Praise God, I hope you're doing fine today. And the topic today is on pleasing everybody. Well, worst thing, right off the bat, let me get my disclaimer in. I'm not here to please you. I'm here to please my Heavenly Father, God. Amen. Praise God. Hello, Brother Greg Dotson. How we doing? For Consumed by Fire Ministries. Hey, everybody, you want to hear some fire-burning preaching? And, some anointed men of God, hey, won't you tune over on Consumed by Fire Ministries at 5 o'clock Monday through Friday. Praise God. And let me tell you something. You'll get something from it every time that brother brings on a service. Praise God. So everybody, like I said, 5 o'clock on Consumed by Fire Ministries. Hit him up on Brother Greg Dotson on Facebook or Consumed by Fire Ministries on Facebook. And tune in and be what God have you to be. Amen. Praise God. You know, today, Lord, I was praying about what God had me to say today. I'm a little late today, so you'll have to forgive me for about that. I went over to a brother and sister today, and we had fellowship. We was praying for one another and talking about some things that we going to be doing in this year, praise God. And this discussion popped up. I says, well, I don't know, that church is going to like this or church is going to like that. Well, let me tell you something. I don't want to worship a building. I worship a mighty God that can break down the walls of deception, jealousy, strife. If we would all get to that same God, you know, Jesus Christ, not a building, not a denominational name, but if we would just get on the same page with Jesus Christ, well, let me tell you something. We could change the world we live in. Amen. Now, I tell you, this world is going to be burnt one day. But let me tell you something. Do you not want to see people get into heaven? Do you not want to see, try to pull somebody back from the pits of hell? See, my friend, our job in life is this. To love, to honor, and obey our Heavenly Father. Praise God. And you know, a lot of people will criticize me because that I don't set up a big church or have a big U-Haul, whatever the slang words are today, or just a big fancy gathering. See, what I do is I'll go into people's houses and talk to them. See, I want to see where they come from, where they met God, what changed their life. I mean, things like that. When you get to know people, you see their burdens. Amen. Now, most people will try to hide the burdens. I ain't going to hide nothing. Because if God can see it, you might as well let man see it too. Because man ain't going to judge you. But God is. See, my friend, that's why we got to stand strong. So my verse, oh, praise God, is in Galatians 1:10. It says, For I do now pursue men or God, or do I seek to please men? For if I yet please men, I should not be a servant of God. See, now, my friends, you got two choices in life. You can be liked and be petted and finer clothes and fancy cars and fancy churches and just be liked of the world. But, my friend, when you do that, you become an enemy of God. See, you're not a servant of God if you rather want to have somebody to give you great report. Amen. You know, the Bible does say that we should have a good report, but in a Christian way, in a love of God way. You know, that's the biggest problem with people today. They think, well, if I don't come in with a suit and tie or a ring or 20 years experience of serving Christ, that I'm not worthy to be able to talk to. See, my friends, if you turn away everybody that what you say is not worthy, you're gonna be very surprised when you step into heaven. And that man that you passed on the street that was preaching the gospel and you thought, wow, he was crazy, he was wild, and guess what? He's around God's throne room too. See, my friends, you got to consider what's around us, my friend. From the smallest prophet to the biggest prophet, they all had one mission. That's right, serving Jesus Christ. Praise God. That's why we got to stand up and proclaim the word of God while we're still here. So my friends, my family, I hope you have made a decision. Praise God. Enjoy this song, I Have Made a Decision.
I have decided I'm going to live like a believer. Turn my back on the deceiver. I'm going to live what I believe. I have decided being good is just a fable. I just can't because I'm not able. I'm going to leave it to the Lord. There's a wealth of things that I profess. I said that I believed. The deep inside I know. Changed. I guess I'd been deceived. Cause a voice inside kept telling me that I'd change by and by. But the Spirit made it clear to me that kind of life's a lie. I have decided I'm gonna live like a believer. Turn my back on the deceiver. I'm gonna live what I believe. I have decided. Thank you.
and amen, I have decided that all the fairy tales that people live their life in is not for me. Amen, praise God. I don't want to live in a life of deception. I want to live in a life of the truth. And that's what we all, amen, old, young, experienced and unexperienced, we just need to trust in Jesus Christ. See, my friends, he is the true life and the way, and only through him that we'll ever see the promised land. Praise God. Like over here in 1 Thessalonians 2:4, it says, but as we were allowed of God to put in trust with the gospel, even as we speak, not as pleasing men, but God, which tires of the heart. Amen. Praise God. You know, now, it doesn't matter how many times that you get caught up in foolish things and you try to help somebody and they just want more and more and more. And when you don't do more, oh, Lord, they get upset. Boy, they just get so mad. Well, I wanted you to do this. Why are you doing that? See, when we take our eyes off of God and onto men, that's when we fall, my friends. See, that's why we got to stand up and say, Lord, I'm here. Use me, make me, shake me, and put me where you need me to be. Praise God. How many times have you gone to church and God has told you to do something, but your pastor, your bishop, or whoever's the leader of the church say, well, we'll do that next week. Well, God told you to do it then. Why don't you do it? I'll tell you why. Because you're trying to please men and trying to make happiness to everybody else. Let me tell you something. They can't get you into heaven. But the true mighty God, our Jehovah God, Jesus Christ, can get you into that great and promised land if you would just listen and obey. Praise God. Today is a day of salvation, my friends. If you want to go to heaven, you better get rid of that old man's rubbish. Praise God, praise God. Let God be God.
Are you living in an old man's rubble? Are you listening to the Father of Lies? Are you walking with unnecessary burdens? Are you trying to take them upon yourself? If you are, then you're bondage, and you know that's bad for your spiritual health. And are you trying to live by your emotions? Are you putting your faith in what you feel and see? Then you're living just to satisfy your passions, and you better be careful because you're being deceived. Are you living in an old man's trouble? Are you listening to the Father? Something's got a hold on you. Deep within you, there's a spiritual battle. There's a voice of the darkness and a voice of the light. And just by listening, you've made a decision. Cause the voice you hear is gonna win the fight. Are you living in an old man's trouble? Are you listening to the Father of Lies? If you are, then you're headed for trouble. If you listen too long, you eventually.
amen. Are you living in old man's rubble? Praise God. So, see, there's so many people that won't let that old man die. They want to hold things what they did back years and years ago. And they think, well, God teach me that, I'll live that away. Well, my friend, sometimes the old man has got to learn new tricks. Amen. Praise God. Especially in this association we got now, praise God, the world is being taught by news, and they're being taught by philosophers and all this nonsense. See, they have forgot to get back to the basics. Amen. Basics of the Word of God. Praise God. You know, like it says over here, praise God, in Proverbs 29:25, the fear of men brings a snare, but who puts their trust in the Lord shall be safe. See, my friend, that's what we got to do. We got to trust in the Lord, mighty God. And that with all our heart, mind, body, soul, and spirit. Not just our opinions, not just our minds. Hey, he wants the whole kit caboodle. See, our Lord don't deal with custody. He wants the whole deal. He don't want to just share you on the weekends. He wants you every day of your life, my friends. See, that's why I get behind this mic when I can, praise God, and tell you that there is a different way of life. There is something that you can do yourself every day, and that's prayer. Praise God that we can all take a moment in time to pray and see what God have us led us to do. See, now that's the problem with the church. Everybody wants to do prayer in that church. Why not do it right where you're at, my friend, where God can make a move on you today? I know that there's people out there right now that is being despised. I know there's people that's being made fun of. I know there's people that look at you and say, well, look how big that man is. He could take better care of himself. Or look at that person that ain't got them best clothes, but he's preaching the Word of God. Well, instead of making excuses, why about you get in their life and help them? I mean, my friends, you know, I get tied up with all kinds of people making excuses and lies. Praise God. But, you know, let me tell you something. Unless you can make a righteous judgment, and you know without a reasonable doubt it is God's judgment, I wouldn't say nothing. I would help. I'd be a servant, what we're both to be, praise God, and do what God have us to do, praise God. So we got some call-ins from Brother Boyd, praise God. He's an awesome prayer warrior. But most of all, he is a man of God that'll bring a word. It ain't no sugarcoating coming out of his mouth, and there ain't going to be none coming out of mine. Only sugar I want is in my Kool-Aid. No, it ain't none of the Jones' deal. I'm not committing suicide. I'm talking about putting a little tap on the back of your sins. I'm not going to step on your sins and say it's a fine thing, because sin is sin, and it will keep you away from heaven. So, my friends, let's hear the word from Brother Boyd from Idaho. Keep him in prayer. Amen.
Hello, Brother Willie. I love you, and I'm praying for you. God bless you. This is Brother Boyd London in Idaho. I'm just going to call in with my testimony here in Idaho, and thanks for keeping us all in prayers. We've got a lot of stuff going on here this week, so next week I'm not sure when I'll be online. Sometimes I can't get online until later at night, but when I get on there, I get a chance. I listen to the programs and the archive programs, and for House of Prayer, your House of Prayer programs are so good, and for the Gospel Music Jukebox ones over on Mixler, they're on the show reel. And thanks so much for doing those programs. They inspire us to live for the Lord, and thanks so much for having this testimony line. And Lord has told me we can help get the good news of Jesus out to this lost, dying, and hurting world through this testimony line. Please call 1-270-681-8098. Share your testimony. And When we get on there, we share those programs over on Ann's Facebook page, and we've got people on there, relatives and friends that don't have Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior, and I hope they get a chance to listen to the programs, because Jesus is the Son of God. He came down to earth. He died on the cross for your sins. He was raised from the dead. He was seated at the right hand of God, and you can turn your heart and life over to Jesus. Have Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. You can make Jesus Lord of your life, and you can have forgiveness of your sins and can be able to go to heaven. I was controlled by pornography, lust, anger, cursing, and so many sins. I confessed Jesus as Lord. I was baptized in a lake, and Jesus helped me get the porn and all those sins out of my life. And I'm not controlled by those. I don't do those sins anymore. I praise and thank and glorify God. And, you know, instead of sinning. Now I do what I'm doing now. I call in and share my testimony with people. And we've been helping people in prisons and mentoring fatherless and orphan kids and doing things to show the love of Jesus to others instead of sinning. Jesus healed me. He healed me of sin. He's healed me so many times in my life. I was healed from a serious back injury, from a car accident, never had to have surgery. We've seen Jesus heal and help so many people, even people with severe drug addiction problems. And I'm telling you, in Matthew chapter 13, Jesus promises if you'll turn your heart and life over to him, he will heal you. And I'm telling you, Jesus has healed me so many times from sin, from different sicknesses and problems. Jesus has healed me so many times over, and I just thank Jesus so much, and I love him. Jesus is Lord, and he's my personal Lord and Savior. If you'll turn your heart and life over to Jesus, you can know the truth, and the truth can set you free. Jesus will help set you free from those addictions and sins. Jesus will heal you from sicknesses and diseases. Jesus took your infirmities and bore your sicknesses on the cross, Matthew 8:17. Father, right now, I just want to come to you in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. I want to pray and ask for you to touch and heal anyone hearing this who needs healing and help. Please touch and heal them from sicknesses and diseases. Please heal them from addictions and sins. Please help them to turn their hearts and lives over to you and your Son, Jesus, if they haven't. Help them to know how much Jesus loves them and that Jesus died on the cross for them. Thank you, Father, for touching, healing, and helping us all today. And I say this prayer in the name of your Son, Jesus. God bless all.
Could change somebody's life today. You know somebody that needs a little touch of God. Why don't you go love up on them? Won't you tell them that God loves them and so do you? And if you don't, you need to be praying. Praise God. See, many people is in depression. So many people that's popping the pill to feel better, my friend. Only pill you need is Jesus. Amen. Is to touch the God that went upon that cross, my friend, to die for you and your sins. See, this is the problem with the world. That's why we got so many churches out around the mountain, especially in Scottsville. We got 93 churches in a 3-mile radius around me right now that won't come together with love and truth and the Spirit of God. I'll tell you why they won't do that. Because everybody wants to be a captain. Everybody wants to be a leader. Everybody thinks they're David. Amen. You know, David that picked up them 5 stones, used 1 stone to take down Goliath. See, my friends, we all can pick up rocks and knock down the devil. Praise God. See, that's why we need to get up and tell the world today that God is not dead. He is very much alive, my friend. And I can tell you this much. If you would put your trust in God and do His will, I'll tell you, God will make a move in your life that's never been made before. So, my friends, enjoy this song here, The Lord Has a Will.
To see me through, I can't get by unless I lean on you, Lord. The Lord has a will, and I have a need to follow that will, to humbly be still, to rest in it, nest in it, fully be blessed in it, following my Father's will.
Father's will. You know, I have a need too, but you know, I gotta obey God's will. Praise God. That's what the main project of the body of Christ is lacking of. They're on their own sidetracks. They're all taking the path that way, this way, that way, in any way but the right way. Praise God. But you know, if you have never met the Lord, you don't know what I'm talking about. But, my friend, there is a path and a destiny that God has prepared for you this very day. Praise God that you can humble yourself down and repent of your sins and accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Praise God. Today is a day of salvation. You got a choice. Do you want to live in ignorance the rest of your life and die and go to hell? Or do you want to accept the truth of the Lord Jesus Christ and be in His will? Praise God. Like it says over here, in Acts 5:29, then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God rather than men. See, my friends, a lot of people are going to put a lot of things in your ears. And they'll put titles on their names saying, they're the big honcho of this, that, and the other. But let me tell you something. When God looks down, He looks down upon nothing but dirty rags. But let me tell you something. If you obey Him and you'll sit still and you'll obey God what He'll tell you to do, let me tell you, He'll change things in your life that you didn't think it was possible. And you will know, praise God, you will know it is of God. See, my friends, you don't have to live in ignorance all your life. See, all you got to do is surrender to the Jehovah God. Amen. Praise God. I hope this next song here, that you know who that Jehovah God is, the great creator of all things, my friend. He is the King of Kings.
your father loves you so. Consider the creatures of the air, for all of the diamonds in all the earth have not the wealth of them. Consider the creatures of the air, Jehovah loves them with tender hand. He knows you every care, his touch is always there to see you through the night. And Jehovah, I love you so. And Jesus, I want you to know all you've done for me to set me free. I'll never let you go. And Jehovah, I love you so. And Jesus, I want you to know all you've done for me to set me free. I'll never let you go. Consider the lilies of the field, for how much more does he love his own? If Yahweh cares for them, consider the creatures of the air. He takes after each and every need. If we ask him for bread, will he give us a stone? Jehovah loves him.
Jehovah God is looking down upon you today and wondering, why are you the way you are? My friends, today, you've got a choice. You could serve the Jehovah God, Jesus Christ, and that Holy Ghost, because they are as one, my friend. You can't run away from God. You cannot hide from God, because God is God, and there is no other God that you can turn to. You know that little fat guy they call the Buddha? Let me tell you something about him. His bones are still in a cave somewhere, praise God. And all these other gods that's been in the last 1,000 years are still dead. But our Jesus Christ is very much alive today, praise God. Praise God. You know, I just got an instant message from Brother, a little bit from everybody. Hey, man. Praise God. I'm going to pass it along to everybody. We are having a all-day gathering at Sister Shirley Collins, October the 11th, 2006, from 10 to whatever Bishop Betty Cheney and Sister Pauline will be here. Everyone is invited to cook out, come and fellowship. Fellowship with us. Also, will be for a Larry Linda Martin. Lyndon Madden, who is leaving for Hawaii. Well, praise God. So everybody that would like to come down to a gathering down there in Pikeville, Kentucky, at Sister Colleen, Sister Collins, Sister Shirley, I'll get it out in a minute, praise God. Come on down. Let's have fellowship. Let's have a good old one, like Grandpa used to say, one of them old barn-burning services. Amen. This fellowship, preach, teach, and love, just love the hell out of somebody. Amen. Praise God. And I understand there's going to be a what they call it, a gathering, and they're going to be departing, praying for somebody that's going over to Hawaii. Well, it's nice. Praise God. I hope she's filled with the Holy Ghost and wins more souls for the kingdom of God. Praise God. But anyways, back to the word, what God had me to say today. Praise God. If you turn over here to, let's see, where was that? Ah, here it is. Second Colossians, Chronicles 5:9. It says, wherever we labor, that we present or absent, we may be accepted of him. See, my friends, a lot of people today thinks that you got to put up a pretty little show to serve God. My friend, there's many times that I've been on back porches preaching, and I felt the power and anointing of God more there than I ever have in the four walls of a building. My friend, sometimes you just got to get out, my friend, and let God be God. See, we're not here to please you. We're not here to pamper you. We're not here to give you diapers to wear because you have fallen short of God. See, what we both to do is give you an enlightenment, my friend, to raise you up from out of that muck and let you stand on dry land and walk through that ocean that's been blocking you from getting to the other side, my friend. That's why God has called me to evangelize, to shake what's in you, to be waking up in you, my friend. I know that you've been in church for 30, 40 years. I do not care how long you've been in a building. I want to know how long has God put a fire on you and you have not done nothing. See, my friend, if God has anointed you, he has a way for you to stand up and proclaim the word of God. If you would like to proclaim the word of God and nobody's giving you an access, hey, call this number, 270-681-8098. And let me tell you something, I'll let you give 3 minutes. If you got more than 3 minutes, call back. Hey, don't be ashamed that God has given you a deliverance or God has given you highly favor. Hey, let the world know that God is not dead. He is very much alive and he is moving in God, in people's, people of God. See, my friends, don't be caught up in fairy tales and nonsense. Today, we need to be caught up in the true word of God. Amen. Praise God. You know, sometimes people need to see old Ezekiel Will. Amen. So enjoy this song, Ezekiel Will.
Ezekiel saw the wheel, way up in the middle of the air. Ezekiel saw the wheel, way in the middle of the air. Ezekiel saw the wheel, way up in the middle of the air. Ezekiel saw the wheel, way in the middle of the air. Ezekiel saw the wheel, way up in the middle of the air. Ezekiel saw the wheel, way in the middle of the air. Ezekiel saw the wheel, way up in the middle of the air. Ezekiel saw the wheel, way in the middle of the air.
You know, sometimes we got to be shaken to the root. Praise God. When people start thinking, well, I got him figured out, that's when you need to stir the pot. Oh, you really got me figured out? Let's just see. Well, come with me on a revival. Hey, how about we go out here on the street and preach? Why don't we go to the smallest nursing home in town and preach the word of God to them? You think you really know me? You come walk with me, my friend. I'll show you. You don't really know me. See, my friends, I serve a mighty king. One day he might tell me that I spent a month at this church. The next thing I know, he tells me go preach on a corner somewhere. See, my friends, I believe that you need to be rooted down in a home church. Without a doubt. Praise God. Praise God. I hope you find somebody that you fall in love with and that they are preaching the word of God. But I'm telling you this much. If you sit on your tail too long, you're going to get a fat butt. Let me tell you something. You got to get up and exercise. Exercise your faith in God, my friend. This ain't time. We have not got time to be pity-patting with people's opinions. Amen. Say that fast 5 times. Praise God. But let me tell you something. All this patting going in church. Oh, this is the mother's church. This is daddy's church. This is Uncle Grandpa Buckwheat's church. It doesn't matter whose church it is. If God's in it, let God know it. Amen. Praise God. See, that's why we need to be paying attention to our Father's house. See, there's so many people in the world today that are caught up in their own wills. Amen. Praise God. They think, well, I could do anything I want because this is my grandpa's church. Let me tell you something. If it's out of the will of God, you need to tell them to get out or repent. See, my friend, I'm not going to sit in somebody's building and say that, hey, I'm going to dedicate my life to this pastor, or I'm going to dedicate my life to this church. My friend, you better dedicate your life to God, because God is the one's going to bring you out of this misery of hell. See, my friends, God is the only truth, life, and the way, and only through Him, amen, that you'll ever see good. Amen. Praise God. So here we go. Let's play the song here, Double the Good to You. Amen. Enjoy.
Softly on your face. If the sunset lingers while cathedral bells peal and the moon has risen to her place, you can thank the Father for the things that He has done, and thank Him for the things He's yet. Lord, He's been doubly good to you.
Amen. If you find the true living God, he will be doubly good to you, my friends. If you would just trust and put your faith in him, praise God. Brother Greg Dotson making fun of me about the buckwheat. Amen. But what I'm trying to tell you is, it doesn't matter if it's your family or if it's a stranger church. You got to treat each other as God treated you. He's forgiven you. He's blessed you home and your family. He let you live another day, my friend. See, too many people are getting caught up in self-worth, amen, when they should be doing what God has said. Pick up your cross and follow him. See, my friends, I don't get on this mic here to entertain you or please you. I serve a mighty king that died upon a cross for me and you and the whole world. That if we would believe, that he would build a place for us to live in eternity. You know, the Lord says in his own words, he says, I go away, prepare a place for you. My friend, if you want to go there, and I ain't talking about making reservations for a hotel or taking a vacation of the world. I'm talking about that great eternity vacation. That we will never have to worry about pain, bills, suffering, heartaches, worrying. I mean, none of that will be in our mind when we leave this earth. See, my friends, we need to keep Jesus Christ in the center focus of us all at all times. No matter what people do to you or how they talk about you, that God has the final call. You know, like it says over here in Galatians 2:20, I am crucified with Christ, nevertheless I live, yet not I, but Christ lives in me, and the life which I now live is in the flesh. I live by faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. See, my friends, that's the thing we need to hold tight, that God come in the flesh. 33.5 years he walked this earth. Then he was crucified. Then the next thing, 3 days later, he arose, having the keys to heaven and hell and the power to lay it down and lift it back up. My friends, there ain't nothing in this world can do that. But I'll tell you what man that can, his name is Jesus. Now, if you're out there and you wonder something, what you're going to do, how you're going to pay your bills, or your kid's a sinner and you don't know what you can do, I'll tell you what you need to do. Take all that stuff that's worrying you and bonding you down to this world and take it to the Lord. And leave it there, my friend. So many times people says, I'm going to take my son to the altar. I'm going to take my daughter to the altar. I'm going to take my family to the altar. But you notice the next week they're taking them back. They're taking them back. My friends, if you got an issue, take it there and leave it there. See, because God's the only one that can really truly heal you, sanctify you, and give you true peace. See, my friends, like I said, I don't get behind this bullpen just to entertain you. I do to please God. And if I can help a soul be pulled back from the pits of hell, I've done my job. But if you're looking for friendship or a buddy, I'm sorry, that's not me. But I know a friendship you can have, and that's Jesus Christ. And this friendship, he'll never leave you. He's always there to listen, and he's always there to talk to you. Now, I get a lot of grief about those who you hear the voice of God. Absolutely. Every decision I make, I hear the voice of God. Now, it might not look right in a man's eyes, but it pleasing to God. There was many times the disciples done crazy things that looked silly to men, but it was pleasing to God. See, my friends, that's where we got to stand with God. No matter if he tells you go out there and put a bikini on and preach the gospel. Wouldn't I look funny with a bikini on? But anyways, I don't know why that come in my head. But anyways, think about it. If God told you to do it, would you do it? See, that's the problem with a lot of people. People want to please people. That ain't our job, my friends. Our job is serving the mighty King. And let God be God in their life. We give them the word. We plant it in their hearts. God waters it. And he reaps it. See, I'm just an old farmer, I guess you say. A servant of God. That was loved enough to be forgiven. See, I ain't truly saved till I walk through them gates. I'm forgiven right now. See, my friends, that's where you need to come and point in your life. That when everything else fails, God never will. So, my friends, my family, that's what God has given me. Oh, yeah, Brother Greg. Yeah, pink polka-dotted bikini. Yeah, I'll be right on that as soon as I see you in one. Wouldn't that be pretty? Anyways, I love you guys. Remember me in the House of Prayer Radio Ministry. Remember the number, 270-681-8098. If you would like to email me, brothergrizzle76@gmail.com. Hey, or hit me up on Evangelist Willie Grizzle on Facebook. Remember, I'm praying for you. You pray for me. We get all this praying going on. We'll be healthy. We'll be strong. And we'll have highly favor in the Lord Jesus Christ. Remember, you got Brother Greg Dotson of Consumed by Fire Ministries on at 5 o'clock. Tune in. Praise God. And let me tell you, he'll light your world, make you mad. Which one of them ever. Either way, it'd be in the will of the Father. Praise God. Let's remember Bishop Eddie Cheney, 7 o'clock, Gospel Music Jukebox. Amen. Let's remember them. And all their ministries, and let Lord show a high favor upon all ministries that's been mentioned today. Praise God. But most of all, keep these men in prayer. Amen. This is yours truly, the Evangelist Willie Grizzle from the House of Prayer, saying, peace be with you. And guess what? God is not in a stained window.
There's so much I don't know. There's so much I don't know. I don't understand why the summer's so hot. I don't understand why an apple core rots. And I have no idea when I'll see a rainbow. But there's one thing I do know. I know that God ain't no stained glass window. And I believe there is a Holy Ghost. I know that God ain't no stained glass window. Cause he never keeps his window closed. There's so much I don't see. There's so much I don't see. I don't see how hair can turn silver gray. I don't see why my prayers can't get answered right away. I don't see why some folks keep a load in their mind with a sharp axe to grind. And I don't understand why the truth takes a twist. I don't understand why there is loneliness. I don't know why they claim that some men have no soul. But there's one thing I do know. I know that God ain't no stained glass window, and I believe that there's a Holy Ghost. I know that God ain't no stained glass window, 'cause he never keeps his window closed. No, he never keeps his window closed.